And this award recognises the work of a musician that has genuinely changed the face of modern music as we know it. Previous recipients include David Gilmour, The Stooges, Yoko Ono, and the man set to join that illustrious list has managed to break down both musical and cultural boundaries. First, as a pioneer of electronic music, and secondly, as the first Western musician to play in China. I must also add that at this stage, he is possibly the only man to ever make Docklands seem like a genuinely appealing destination. Despite huge mainstream success that has seen him sell in excess of 80 million albums, his ideological view of music is epitomised by one project released in 1983, Music for Supermarkets. You may not know it. Why should you? There's only one copy in existence. The master tapes were burnt. The point being that music is incredibly valuable. It was a point well made way before we reached today, a point made several years ahead of its time. I could go on eulogising this man, but I think I should hand over to somebody else. To present the award, please welcome to the stage a man who is himself a visionary of British electronic music. 30 years ago, he left Ultravox to carve out his own singular musical path, and most recently, he's released an album with the Cocteau Twins, Robin Guthrie. Ladies and gentlemen, he is the metamatic genius himself, John Fox.
I first heard this award winner's music in 1970-something. And then I was looking for a kind of music that would unite Europe and England and get rid of punk and make something sort of interesting and civilized and melodic, and knit together and stitch together all the bits of stuff that I liked a lot. And when this came along, it really sickened me off, because it was better than I'd imagined it could be. It was Tangerine Dream mixed with French film music and everything that I loved, even classical music. And I hated the guy who made it, because he had a flat in Paris and his own recording studio there. And he had the most beautiful wife anyone's ever seen. And even his father was a composer of film music. And he just went on and on being excellent in everything he did, while I didn't.
Thank you very much. I must first of all thank you, Mojo, and for being in the middle of all these great people. I'm having a real good time, so thank you very much. And also to be in London tonight and not being in South Africa with a French team. And you know, yes, I have a thought also for Ireland tonight. And also, no, I'm really pleased and honored to receive this award, because I always had a very special relationship to your country, in spite of my very subtle Gaelic accent. For personal and artistic reasons, I mean, your country gave me a lot. When I started electronic music, I did my first album, and I think I sold 117 copies. Today, a quite respectable number and figure, but not at that time. Then, when I wrote Oxygen, I mean, it has been refused almost by every record company. The guys were saying, yeah, okay, there is no singer, tracks are not able to be played on the radio, tracks are lasting 10 minutes, and on top of it is French. So, then Radio One played the entire album, and it started for me like this in this country. So I'm particularly pleased to receive this award. You know, it's always very exciting to be at the beginning of a new genre like electronic music for me. But even if you don't realize it, or if you realize it much later on, I would like to thank actually all these guys without who I won't be here, and John. Certainly not as well, people like Robert Moog and all these people, fantastic craftsmen who designed like the Les Paul for the electric guitar, but for these great unbeatable analog synthesizers. Another thing I would like to say also is actually I tried to visualize also my music, because I thought that being behind the laptop is not during 2 hours is not maybe the most exciting or most sexy thing in the world. So I went to work with lots of great designers and people involved in videos and lasers and lights and really complementing electronic music performance. Actually, one last thing is I would like to thank two people. Mr. Francis Dreyfus, the president of my first record company, who gave me the chance to do all these records, and my manager here, Miss Fiona Cummins. Thank you. You know, it's quite strange to receive a Lifetime Achievement Award, because in days where lots of people of my generation are doing their first or second or third farewell tour, actually I'm starting my first real world tour. So I'd be glad to be back in 20 years for my Life Achievement Award Part 2. Thank you very much. Good night.